I was irritated all day yesterday.
What was really getting to you?
Well, first, I think it was overwhelming on an emotional level. I woke up, and it was the first tragedy that I woke up, I looked at my phone, and I went, oh, Jesus. I mean, I was genuinely flabbergasted. I'm a news junkie. Not much moves me, but this really, like, wow. Immediately turned on CNN, started watching it, and I just was like, what is going on here? I mean, it was hard to get your head around. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, in the afternoon, the stories start to really roll in of people who were lost and how they were lost. And I was watching the press conference with the White House spokesperson, and she broke up at one point. Reporters were breaking up. And I'm an emotional person. So when I see people choke up, I choke up too. And then I went and read the story about the married couple. They've been married a year. They went to this concert. They flew out to the concert. He ended up shielding himself to save his wife, and I was in a Chili's eating lunch, and I lost it. Like, I didn't lose it. I didn't ugly cry, but I definitely teared up as I was eating.
Well, how could you not?
It's so moving. And then the responses that morning of just watching people just shield each other, and the heroism, the true heroism. I mean, like, I saw a reporter on CNN yesterday. This lady was giving blood at, like, 7 p.m. that night. And the reporter was like, thank you so much. You're a hero. And I'm like, the fuck she is. She's giving blood. That's not a hero. Okay, we use the word hero way too often in this country. You're not a hero. The people who are shielding their bodies, shielding their wives with their body to save their life, those are heroes. Those people who are running. Like, there was a young African-American kid, a black kid with a patch on his shoulder. He had been shot in the shoulder. He had gotten his family to safety, and then he started running after a group of girls who were stuck in the middle of the firing lines, got shot in the shoulder. That bullet's going to be there forever. He's permanently scarred trying to save the lives of other people. That's a hero. And then you get so pissed at this motherfucker who goes up and just starts shooting innocent people for what reason? There's no reason for it. Even if we had a motive, there still wouldn't be a reason for it. It's like, what kind of monster does this? Who puts this much time and effort into such a demonic act? I mean, it just doesn't make any sense. And then you get on Facebook and you see these selfish motherfuckers trying to force their stupid political narrative into a tragedy to emotionally manipulate people, good people who are on Facebook and who are watching this grieving, and then they have to deal with manipulation from fucking liberals who want to use a tragedy to try and manipulate people into a bullshit narrative that wouldn't have prevented this tragedy anyways. They're using people's ignorance. Their own ignorance is using other people's ignorance to be more ignorant. And it just gets so frustrating and pisses me off so much because it's like watching a political movie. I get pissed off because I know too much about it. It's like a doctor watching ER. And I just watch this and I go, you are not a good person. If you took the opportunity yesterday to post about gun control, because you're using a situation, the tragedy of these people lying in a parking lot, people who are trying to have a fun time with their friends and family, and then they see other people dying around them, and then you are using that to push your personal political narrative because you feel like you're being some fucking brave hero getting online and talking about gun control when you have never fired a gun, you don't know shit about guns, you have no idea how public policy works, your platitudes about banning all guns makes you look as stupid as me saying today, why don't we ban all murder? You look like a fucking idiot. And I hope that you feel bad every single night when you go to sleep for manipulating people in a time of tragedy because you're a bad person. And I hope that you delete your status and then your Facebook account and self-abort. So that's why I was pissed off, Greg.
I second. Can I get an aye? Can we pass this as legislation?
Right.
Liberals should self-abort.
Right.
If you're they're pro-choice. They should self-abort and prove how pure they are.
Right. It just, you know, and the right does it too. Like, the first thing, it's like 17 of my Facebook friends, oh, we got to ban the fucking Muslims. Like, you don't know shit. You don't know anything about anything. We don't even know now, 48 hours later, anything about this guy. We don't know anything about the case. We don't know anything. You're not a fucking expert in criminology. You don't know shit. Shut up.
Yeah, the case isn't done.
Las Vegas is a sanctuary city.
And let's be clear.
Right. Shut up.